Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today, and I'm covering with you major updates coming from Europe and of course more stuff we have to look into, especially when it comes to the expansion of the capacity to produce cars for Tesla. And for that, we first go to Troy Teslaik, who shared with us a date till when we could maybe expect a new announcement for a new factory by June 10th in 2022. The reason behind that, if we want to start a new factory in every 2 years time, that would be around about the time we would need to announce a new factory to get it ready by beginning of 2024. And we do know that Tesla is not stopping here, so I'm just going to grab here the tweet from Andrej Bacina from Slovakia, who has apparently a reliable source that told him that Tesla is starting a hiring process for a second factory in the European Union. So the thing here is we just still have to take that cautiously, but I just want to go after this tweet and just explain you why it could make sense for Tesla to do that. First of all, we do know that Grünheide is a very complicated place, and even at some point when the Model 3 and the Model Y will be full producing, we do know that based on Shanghai and the market possibilities from Shanghai here, with over 1 million cars maybe already produced this year, the demand in Europe won't be different. It won't be different, and there are a lot of possibilities to bring this factory to 1 million cars just with the Model 3, just with the Model Y. And just consider here, the Model Y standard range didn't come from the beginning on here in Shanghai, so there's even more room to grow. And taking that into consideration, it might make a lot of sense for Tesla to have a separate factory that maybe concentrates in Europe, not on the Roadster. I don't believe that so much, but I would rather say the Model S and the Model X. And just for Slovakia, Mr. Andrej Karpathy is from Slovakia, so there might be some connection here, possibilities that Tesla is moving to Slovakia. Again, for the Cybertruck, I did some research for you guys. In 2013, there were around 50,000 pickup trucks sold, and in 2018, 114,000. And we also see that Slovakia is not in a bad location when you take the European continent. It's actually in a pretty central location if you take Belarus, Ukraine, towards Moscow as well, inside this entire European continent. And for 2018, there were 114,000 pickup trucks sold. And then in 2021, it was around about 100,000 as well because of COVID, etc. So the market is pretty small, but I believe that these pickup trucks are not sold anymore that much because they are gasoline cars and not electric cars. And of course, the Cybertruck is different. And I think it would make a lot of sense for Tesla to move a factory into Europe for the Cybertruck Model S and Model X. It could make sense so that they can go after the premium people that really like to have a premium car, and on the other hand, able to sell Cybertrucks directly in Europe. Furthermore, looking to Alan Dale, we do have here an update as well from Tesla officially. In Q4 2021, there was one crash every 4.31 million miles. So that is, again, another increase. It shows how safe the autopilot is compared to the average one crash per 484,000 miles in the United States. Again, I just want to go back one more time to the Cybertruck as we are looking into Austin. I believe that the demand for the Cybertruck on the North American continent will be so high that Tesla could be deciding to make a Cybertruck as well in Slovakia or in a different place in Europe in a smaller factory and get the supply from the biggest battery factory in Grünheide, which could be the biggest battery factory at some point in Europe, And that makes a lot of sense to do that for Tesla. Furthermore, until then, the Cybertruck would be really hitting the road here in Austin, and they would have already all the experience for a ramp up. Furthermore, looking at the solar roof in Nevada compared to last year of the 12th of January, we do clearly see some development here. We do see that the solar roof is getting installed here in Nevada. Furthermore, in Austin, we have discussed many times that here the update might come very soon, that the solar roofs might be installed. Here is still the question if there will be a name like Tesla, that everyone sees that on the solar roof. That will be still the question to ask. Furthermore, we will go into the TV ads that car makers are investing in. In the dark blue section, you do see the EVs, but consider that the amount of money spent here is also for hybrid cars, so it's not 100% EVs. So we still see that a lot of car makers are investing huge amount of money into gasoline cars in the TV ads. This shows that these car makers are still believing they can do a lot of money with that. If it would be a wise decision to further promote cars that they are doing money with or moving into the future by attracting maybe new consumers to your brand, this is the question to ask. I'm seeing here a trend where I'm believing that these car makers will eventually have to change the game, especially when they are not able to catch up. So taking GM here, for example, GM is a good example where we could see Tesla really moving forward here, and GM having the only option to catch up by pushing a lot of money in TV ads. And if that would result in more consumers buying GM electric vehicles at some point, that is a different question. Otherwise, here in Germany, I do believe that VW is already a bit moving into the EV space when it comes to TV ads, but not as much yet. So there's still a lot of improvement that could be done. They are furthermore moving into YouTube reviewers that are reviewing the cars here in Germany a lot. This is where Daimler, BMW and others are spending a lot of money to get those promoted online. So that is a way to do it as well. But here it is mostly regarding the premium vehicles. I do know that some of you guys are also watching from Germany. If you do so, I also have the channel Tesla Mac, and I also have a Tesla podcast, but unfortunately so far only in German. You can find me there.